Right, guys, I'm playing Fortnite on the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 4. Like I said, I'll be getting the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 5. Hopefully, I hope, fingers crossed, I'll be getting that really soon. I'll be getting that by next week. And, yeah, you know. I'm just wondering why these screen controls keep coming out on the phone. So, basically, what I'm doing here is I'm using a DualSense controller to play the game. You see it's connected here. There it is. And it's connected via Bluetooth. Like I said last time, it's a pain in the ass to get this connected. Because sometimes you think it is connected when it's not. And then that just gives you a whole lot of headaches. The Steam Deck in the background. I will be doing some Counter-Strike 2 gaming later on after this. It's just that the videos I kept making, they start getting confusing. Because all the videos are Counter-Strike videos, you know. And then it's like, I don't know what I've uploaded, what I have not uploaded. So I decided in between those videos to make Fortnite videos. I mean, it makes more sense, doesn't it? What are those green things? You know those... Are these... Is that what these represent? Because look, I wonder what those were. I was seeing them on the map a lot. Just wondered. So are those like gas stations and everything? Is that a gas station? Wait, can I blow that up? Righty, righty, right. Let's try and get the gun. Get the gun is gone. Look at the car. It's flying. Oh my god, is that... I'll probably need that later. Let me not destroy it. Oh, there's a bike. Yeah, I don't need the car then. But someone else could have used it. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to leave it alone. I mean, other people may want to use that that car. So I'm not going to mess around with it. Just leave it alone. How do I find Fortnite on Android? It's good. It's really good. It's not bad. It's not a bad kind of game. I mean, listen, I didn't even have to map the controller. That's how good I find it. What I mean, if you don't understand mapping, it's like what you change, what your buttons do on your gamepad. So when I say I didn't have to map it, what I'm talking about is I didn't have to change anything on the controls to get the game working. You understand? It's like... Wait, can I get this thing? So I didn't need to do anything to get the game working. And the other advantage that I have is it's just interesting. I mean, I haven't played this game in such a long time. And when I discovered that I could download this from the Galaxy Store on the Samsung, then why not play it? Because I haven't played this in like 2 years, I think. The last time I played this game, I played this on iPhone. Someone's shooting me. Oh my god. Wait, if he didn't see me. Oh, there he is. Oh, oh my god. I don't know what's wrong with these people. They're just interested in those swords. You know? If you ever seen these bombo classes, I call them. All they're interested in is, I've got a sword. Look, I got a sword. I'm gonna use my sword. And I'm like, why can't you grow up? I wonder who these kids. They get the sword and then that's all they want to do. Sword fighting. This game is all about guns, man. I don't understand why the brothers sword nonsense in. I mean, it's cool. If you want to use swords, yeah, use the sword. But, I mean, at the end of the day, that might mess up the game. Because this game is all about skill. And I don't see how you can have skill. You know, I hate shotguns. I'd just rather have something else in place. I'm wondering why the screen is showing the controls. Or do I need to unfold it a bit more? I just don't like having shotguns, man. Oh, but you know what? I can't have too many snipers with me as well. I'll swap. Get this one. Because most of the time when I'm playing this game, you know what, yeah? It doesn't show the controls. So that's why I'm wondering. Like, why are the controls there? I'm just saying, why are the controls showing up? That's what I'm talking about. So if you don't understand what I'm saying, I'm talking about the controls. Those touch controls shouldn't be appearing. Usually when I'm playing with a DualSense controller, it doesn't do that. So that's why I'm wondering why the The touch controls have come out. Wait, what kind of gun is that one? Oh, it's a shotgun, but it might be better than this thing. So, what I'm saying is, if you want to get this working with sound, you just need to use a Bluetooth speaker. Any Bluetooth speaker will do. If you want to download this onto your phone, the best option, I would say, if you've got a Samsung, and I know I have said this so many times, and I know people might not understand why I keep saying Samsung, because Samsung does have a store called Galaxy, and on the Galaxy store itself, wait a minute, I'm going the wrong way. I just realized it. I wonder where this guy's going. Oh my God. So what I'm saying is, if you've got a Samsung phone, most Samsung phones have this store called the Galaxy Store. It's like a Play Store, but it's got its own apps for Samsung. And a lot of these apps, you will find Fortnite in the Galaxy Store. So it's just like downloading any app from the Play Store, except it's Fortnite. So that's one of the advantages I find about this. So basically, if you want Fortnite, you got a Samsung phone. If you just look for the other store I'm talking about, if you can find the store called Galaxy Store, it's red, I think, in color, and it's really in Galaxy. It's just like Galaxy Store. It's a Samsung app. If you have a Samsung, look for the Galaxy Store and then search for, if you don't find Fortnite, then search for Epic Games. And if Epic Games is in your phone, then you'll get Fortnite. Because that's how you get Fortnite, basically. Fortnite comes from the Epic Games app that you download onto your Android phone. And then you get Fortnite from there. And you install it just like you would any other app, directly from the Galaxy Store on your Samsung. I said this so many times. If you have a folding phone, any folding phone from Samsung, it doesn't matter if it's the first folding phone, Galaxy Store will be there. That's the easiest, and those phones are dead cheap now. You can actually get them really cheap. And wait, does this have a scope? You can get them dead cheap now. And then basically, let's say you've got your phone, the first one, the Z Fold, the first Z Fold, or the Z Fold 2, because I think that one's slightly better. It's got a better screen on the front, basically. But I mean, any Z folding phone. All the Z folding phones have the Galaxy Store. Now, why am I saying folding phone? Because if you unfold it, the screen is just bigger. You see what's going on. The reason why it's showing this, because it's recognizing two screens. I knew there was an issue there, but I mean, I don't know how to fold it in the way that it's gonna like want me to recognize it as one screen. That's why the controls are showing. I mean, the touch controls. Once it recognizes as one screen, that'll all be gone. I mean, the touch controls will go away. So why do I keep talking about Fold? Because the Galaxy Store is on the Fold. And if you can get a folding phone, you do get double the screen ratio. And I think the game is just going to look a whole lot better if you're using a folding phone. And you look much cooler playing a game on a bus, on a train, with a folding phone, wouldn't you? Than if you just had a normal, ordinary phone. So what I'm saying is it just looks cooler. One, two, you get more screen real estate. The game looks a whole lot nicer. Three, the game looks nicer on a much larger screen. And four, you can actually multitask a lot more on a folding phone than you would on a normal Samsung phone. That hence the reason why so many people are buying the Z Fold 5. Or even the, what you call this phone? Trying to remember the phone. There's another popular phone that people are buying, the Samsung Galaxy S series, like the S22, S21 Ultras, S23 Ultras, because those do come with a stylus, so they're good for multitasking. So what I'm basically saying is, you know, even if you cannot afford a brand new Samsung phone, you can still get the folding phones. That's why I'm saying the advantage of folding phones is just basically you're going to get more screen real estate. You understand? You can multitask better. Movies, anything you do on a folding phone will always look a whole lot nicer than any other phone you can actually buy. So that is one of my things. That's why I'm saying. One of those things where it just looks like a waste of time. You know, I'm running out of bullets as well. Right. So what I'm saying is, buy yourself the very first folding phone from Samsung, the one with the small screen, or like I said, the Z Fold 2 is better. Get that phone. You'll get the Galaxy Store on that, guaranteed. Download Epic Games, then get Fortnite. Play it with the unfolded screen on, multitask to your heart's desire. Enjoy the phone. If you can't afford the first Z Fold or the Fold 2 for whatever reason, I don't know what those reasons may be. I'm just saying, if you can't afford them for whatever reason, then you won't run out of options, you know? You will not run out of options. I need to swap this gun. You won't run out of options. You can always get a different phone. I use an Oppo phone, so I mean, it's not bad. I've got an Oppo Reno 8 Pro 5G. I mean, the last time I checked on GSM, there's an Oppo Reno 10. I was quite shocked. Because you know what? I thought my phone was the latest phone. I mean, it was new when I got it. We won. But what I'm saying is, I'm always looking at people and telling them and saying, listen, I mean, they talk to me and I say to them, you can play Fortnite on your phone. They say, oh, I got a PlayStation 5. I'm like, yeah, that's cool. But don't you want something portable, something you can just walk around with and just play at any time? Because this guy, he moves around a lot, you know? And he's like, yeah. I'm like, just buy a Samsung phone. And he's like, ah, this is Samsung. You know, he's not a Samsung fan, but he's an iPhone fan. And I say, listen, buy the Fold phones. One, because they're cheap. I'm talking about the first Z Fold. And I said to him, listen, buy the Z Fold 2 if you can, because it's got a bigger screen on the front. Just, you know, because obviously he doesn't want to lose screen real estate. And he's like, why buy the Fold if I can just buy any Samsung phone? I said, listen, you can multitask on the phone. You can have three apps running on the screen, on the Fold, unfolded screen. You can run three apps on the phone. You can't do that on an iPhone. iPhone can run two apps at most. But if once you start playing the video on iPhone on the split screen, the video will take the full screen. I've got apps that I use. They do that all the time. You might get one or two apps that might allow you to watch a video, but it will cancel the sound of the other video, or it will take the entire screen of the iPhone. So I know what I'm talking about. And I tell the guy, you can't do the multitasking of three apps on the Samsung on the unfolded screen. You can't do that on an iPhone. You can split the screen in half, can watch videos, but, and I actually show him because he thinks I'm lying. Or I mean, he thinks I'm making things up. And I say, okay, I've got this app. I've got the 14 Pro Max, and I say this is the new phone. Before the 15 came out, I say, check this out. And it's a split screen. He's like, oh, cool, you can multitask. And I said, watch this. I want to watch a YouTube video. And I play the YouTube video. What happens? It takes the whole screen. And then he says, oh, my God. And then, he's shocked, you know, because he thought he was going to play in its own screen. It's because he's thinking it's split screen. It's going to play on this side. Take the whole screen on the iPhone. I'm trying to prove a point to him, because if he sees it, he sees proof, he's going to understand. If you just talk to this guy, he's not going to take you seriously. So what I did with him is I said to him, okay, fine. And then I had a different application, app. It's not that popular on App Store, but I had a different app. And one video was playing here, but the other video was silent. You understand? And then he's like, oh, okay, but you can still watch the video. I was like, oh, yeah, cool. But if you put headphones on, the only sound you hear is that video that's making sound, not that one. Unless you stop that one and then play this one. And then that's not playing. And then you're playing one video only. So what's the point of the split screen? It's pointless. And then I showed him this fold that doesn't unfold. I was like, why doesn't it unfold? Yeah, I told him it's a long story. I bought it like that, blah, blah. It was cheap. He said, cool. I opened up three apps for him. I got the YouTube video running here. I had something like a Note or a Chrome or something. But I was writing something on one side. And then lower here, I had some... You know, like I said, I like researching stuff. So it's a news app open. And I'm showing this guy, and he's looking at this. And he's like, that's like an iPhone. I said, the iPhone can't open three apps. And then I showed him on the stylus. I can do screenwriting, and I'm sending him messages from the Samsung to his iPhone. And he's getting it, you know, like a screenshot. He's getting the actual writing. Everything is there. And he's like, wow, so you can do all those things. I said, yes. And then I said to him, listen, if you want... the best phone right now, you buy the older the Z Fold phones, the old ones, not these new ones, because $1,000 is a lot of money. If you buy the Z Fold 4, for like, if you can get it right now, I think it's $700. If you can get the Z Fold 3, those go for about $500. So I said to him, just try to get the first one or the second one, because the screen real estate on the front is good on the Z Fold 2. The first one, the screen real estate is slightly smaller on the outside screen. I'm not talking about inside, but outside. And also the first one shows the cameras inside. So if you don't want that, then get the Z Fold 2 or the Z Fold 3. I think the 3 is a bit better, because I say the Z Fold 3 is actually similar to the Z Fold 4. So I'm explaining all this stuff to this guy, and it just took a while for him to understand that what I was trying to say to him basically is just, it's all about multitasking. So I'm just trying to explain to him that everything I'm trying to tell him is all about multitasking. So if you can multitask on an iPhone and you're happy with what you're doing, then cool, you keep your iPhone. But if you can't multitask on it, then you're going to need an older Z Fold phone. And I know people are like, yeah. I've got iPhones. I've got the old iPhones. I'll show you now, because maybe you think I'm joking. That's the SE. They no longer update this. This only goes up to 15.7.1. You see? It still works. Still works. And I think I've got some apps on this. I mean, I've got widgets on this one. You understand? So I still use it. It's crazy, but I still use the phone. I mean, it's really old. You'd think I'll just put it in the drawer and forget about it, but I still use it. Sometimes when I don't want a big screen phone, I don't want to hold my 11 Pro Max or my iPhone 12. I just want something small, tiny. It's gonna fit in my pocket, and then basically I just wanna do some other things, right? You notice the touch controls are gone. It's like a miracle, right? So basically, what I'm saying is, if I want a tiny phone, I just reach out for my SE. And it's the 2016 SE. It's not these other SEs that recently came out. Okay, you can't break through that. Right. Oh, my God. Oh, my God, I fell. What I'm saying is, for multitasking purposes, and hopefully someone's listening to me on this one, it's a good idea just to buy something that you could potentially use. So if you can potentially use a Z Fold 1 and you're happy with it, then good for you. If you want to use the Z Fold 2 because of screen real estate, fantastic. If you can afford the Z Fold 3 for about, I think they go for about $350, $400 now. They're not really that expensive anymore. But the Z Fold 3 has been compared so many times to the 4 and the 5. And I know the 5 is much smaller, much slimmer. But I'm just telling you that, yeah, because, sorry, when I went into the shop and I asked them, I said, can I see the Z Fold 5? The lady held the phone. I haven't bought the iPhone from them. I bought it from somewhere else. The iPhone that I use for recording is a 14 Pro Max. It's 1 terabyte. I bought that for $1,000. I bought it I bought it early this year. Way before the announcement of the 15 Pro Max. I was actually waiting for the Ultra, but the Ultra never came out. So I was really disappointed. It really disappointed me, man. You know, but I was happy about the Type-C, because I was telling people, now I don't need to carry two chargers on me, you know? I can just carry one charger. So I was happy about that, you know? Let me try building before someone knocks it down. You know, these weirdos, instead of helping me, they just want to break stuff. So what I'm saying is, sorry, I'm just trying to concentrate on building this before someone comes and messes up my plans. Ah, damn, come on. I kind of just build. Why, does this stuff have to be connected or something? Ah, yes, built. Nice one. So what I'm saying is, I always try and give people the best advices that I learned from, you know? And I mean, it's not always taken lightly by people. They think I'm showing off to them. Oh, you've got this phone, you've got that phone. I'm like, yes, but I'm trying to explain to them. You know, the guy even asked me, what should he buy between the you know, the what you call this thing, between the 14 Pro Max and the 15 Pro Max. And I actually told him, I said, listen, buy the 15 Pro Max because of the charger. I mean, the cable. Because it's going to save you a lot of headaches. No one wants to buy the, what you call this, the 14 Pro Max and get stuck with the Lightning charger. I think a lot of people don't realize that when they did that, they killed off the Lightning charger, you know? People actually think it's okay. It's like, oh, it won't affect nothing. It will affect a lot of things because people don't seem to realize whenever these guys change something, and that was major, that was a huge change, you know, it's like they're killing off what they had before. They do that all the time when they don't want to support something anymore. They do it a lot. They do it all the time. And I told my friend, I said, don't bother yourself with buying, you know. Don't bother yourself. Oh, my God. I ran out of materials. Hopefully, someone will find that and use it, you know, for a good purpose. Right. So what I'm saying is, I told my friend, I said, don't bother buying these older iPhones. And he simply doesn't understand why I was saying that. And I said to him, there's no purpose in buying the old iPhone because of the Lightning cable. Once these guys change something, they never go back, you know? They simply don't go back. They're not going to go backwards. Apple has never gone backwards. When they change something, it's permanent. You understand? It's always made on a permanent basis. And I always tell my friends like that, do not buy old stuff. And he's like, but, you know, he doesn't have the money for the 15 Pro Max and all this nonsense. And I said, listen, save up the money and then buy the iPhone 15 at least, or the Pro if you can get it. You know, look for it. I mean, you might find it. If you look for it, you're definitely going to find someone selling it. Because there are a lot of these, what do they call them, those Samsung fans and then the iPhone fans. So obviously there's going to be someone out there that simply doesn't want to have an iPhone for whatever reason. And they probably get these iPhones easily because of contract or whatever, you know? And if you can't get the... What happened? Why is he doing that? Why? I want to ride the bike. That was weird. Did you see that? It's like, oh my God, wait. This guy is right here. Oh my God. He didn't even see me. I got him. He didn't even see me. You saw that? He didn't see me. I was like, I'm trying to get on the bike here. Wait, there's another person. There's another person right there. Oh my God. This is like Christmas. Oh, where did she go? Oh my God, she's gone. Right? So I'm saying, I said to the guy, don't buy anything old, especially if it's Apple. Because Apple does not go backwards. They always go forwards. If they change something and it's major, that was major. That Type-C cable, I don't think a lot of people realize how major that was. They think it's a small change, you know. It's just, oh, you know, they're always doing that. No, they're not always doing that. They don't change what they like making. They didn't want to change Type-C in the first place. You see? So it was one of those things, changes they had to do. So I tell people, like, if you buy something old, let it be something else. What's going on here? You see that? I don't get that. I'm going to go where everyone else is. Where's everybody? Okay, they're over here. I'm going where everyone is. Because it's just boring over there. Oh, look. This guy is right behind you. Come on. Ah, nice one. Where's the other person? So I told my friend, I said, listen, if it's Apple and they've changed something, never buy anything that's old. Because when they change something, they don't just change. They didn't just change the hardware. You know, people don't realize what these dudes are always doing with Apple. Do you know that my 14 Pro Max right now, when I try to open up the camera app, I mean, sorry, the phone app, it is really slow. When I tried to open up the camera app today, because I make videos on the 14 Pro Max, it was really slow to open. And I recently updated it with the 17 beta, whatever you want to call it. If I hadn't updated this phone, for example, and I just kept it on the 16, I bet you'd be much quicker. So what are they doing? They want to force people to buy the new iPhone. And they've been accused of doing this before with battery gates and all these other things. You know, they're always doing this. They do this all the time. My iPhone 14 Pro Max right now is kind of slow when it's opening up the phone app. It's kind of slow when it's opening up the camera app. And I'm thinking, this is not normal for the iPhone. You understand? And my iPhone is not old. The good thing about mine is that it's got a warranty until next year. I did go on the trade thingy because you can trade. I wanted to see if I could actually get a trade-in. Like I said, I wanted to also get a terabyte Pro Max 15. Why do I always go for those? Because it's easier to get another phone. If you need to get another phone, it'll be much easier. You see? It's a whole lot easier. Because if I try to get the lower range iPhone, and then next year the 16 comes out, or the Ultra finally comes out, it'll be much harder, much more difficult for me to actually acquire, for me to actually get the 16 that I wanted, like the Pro Max. It's much harder. But if I get the same tier as I get with what I've got now, I'll actually have an easier time getting the 16 Pro Max. Even if I don't get the terabyte, I can still get the Pro Max. If you go for a lower tier iPhone, what happens is you lose that ability to buy something that you could have bought before. You understand what I mean? So you may not be able to buy the same phone that you wanted to buy. That's what I'm saying. You see, you can't just swap out the old for the new just because it's there. You got to think about these things. So, for example, if I just bought the simple 15, the iPhone 15, which would probably mean I pay them nothing. I just trade in the phone. They accept the trade-in, and then I pay nothing. Because the trade-in they gave me value is $893, I think, for the phone that I've got. Because I wanted to trade in for the 15 Pro Max. And, okay, so if they give me that 800, that's like the 15. So let's say I just get the 15. I pay nothing. They take the trade-in. My phone goes, and then I get the 15. The normal 15. Not the Pro Max, not the Pro, not the Plus, just the 15. What's going to happen next year? I want the 16. What's going to happen? That trade-in value is going to be greatly depreciated to something much less. So what's going to happen after that? I will not be able to get the 16 that I want. Even if it's a Pro Max, I'll have to pay at least a grand on top. You see? So you never, ever go for something lower than what you have just because it's old. No. Even if it costs $1,600, I have to come up with $800 to buy the 15 Pro Max, the 1 terabyte. Why am I doing that? So I just stay within the league of getting the next phone that will be a Pro Max. Like I said, I don't think I'll be able to keep doing this, to buying phones for a grand. You know, it's everything nowadays is becoming more and more expensive. I may not be able to do this anymore. So what I'm trying to do right now, I kind of came to a decision. I did want the Pro Max, the 15, but I just decided to leave it alone until I actually can get one at the price that I want. Now, the reasons for why I'm doing this is because I don't see a problem with having the phone that I currently have. There's nothing wrong with the 14 Pro Max that I've got. It's working. It's totally fine. Yes, it still has a lightning cable. That's still boring to carry two cables on the bus. But to be honest, as long as the phone is still working and there's nothing physically wrong with the phone, I just don't see a point in swapping it at the moment. I mean, listen, if I made $800, for example, if I was able to make that $800 that Apple wants me to pay them, then of course I would try my best to get the Pro Max, the 15 Pro Max. But if I can't do it, then I just have to leave it. I'm not going to force myself, because what's going to happen is you get desperate and then I'll end up getting the 15 or 15 Pro, which is what I don't want. I want the Pro Max. And then what's the point? No point. So I just thought to myself, maybe what you need to do, and listen, I'm also paying $1,100 for the Z Fold 5. So when I get it, I'll show you guys. It will be in the box. It's next to a brand new phone, basically. When they showed me the phone, they showed me the box, the manual's there, the charger. I don't know, cables, whatever it comes with. I don't know if it comes with the charger, but I know it comes with cables. It's got everything it's supposed to have. So that's why I'm saying that after paying $1,100, I just don't feel like I want to spend another $800 on a phone. And the only reason why I'm even doing this in the first place, buying the phone, is because this phone, the one that I currently have, cannot unfold. And my friend was laughing at it and saying it's a dumb idea to buy a phone for $1,000 just because of that reason. And I said, it would be dumb, but then you don't have the phone that I've got. That's the only problem. And because you've never used a Samsung Galaxy Z Fold in your life, it's difficult for you to understand why I want it. You know, it's difficult for him because he doesn't understand. Why do you want this Z Fold thing when you've got an iPhone 14 Pro Max, you've got all these other great phones, why do you need that? And I'm like, listen, I'm buying it for the experience of having a phone. I know it sounds dumb, but that's the real reason. I want the experience of owning something new, something that unfolds properly. When I get on the bus, I want people to look at me opening this Samsung Z Fold 5 and for them to know it's a Z Fold 5. So the case I'm going to buy is going to be transparent at the back to show the color so people know it's the Z Fold 5. And why am I like that? I don't know, man. It's like people are different. Some people buy Mercedes-Benz. Some people buy BMW. Some people will buy a private jet. Some people buy they'll go to California and buy a casino because they're billionaires. They want to be seen. Everyone has a niche. Some people are beautiful. They wear beautiful makeup. Some people drink. They want to buy the most expensive alcohol. Or they drink a certain brand. They want to be seen drinking that brand only. They won't drink anything else. People are different. I'm just different. I just want what I want because to me it gives me satisfaction. You know, I don't drink. I don't smoke. I don't do anything outside. I don't go out. I just stay at home. I'm a homeboy. I'm a mommy's boy. So I'm just that person that stays at home. Well, I don't live with my parents. I'm just saying, I'm that kind of person that stays away from trouble. I stay away from people. So for me, when I have something that I can actually use, I can actually multitask. What I want to do with these kind of phones is I want to read the news because I'm that kind of person. I want to know what's going on in the world. I can't do this on this phone. I can't even unfold it. I'm even afraid that if I try to unfold this, it'll crack the screen. And then this phone would be worthless after that. So I'm leaving this. So then when I get the Z Fold 5, this will be the one I leave at home. This will just stay here. And I'll carry around the Z Fold 5 with my 14 Pro Max. And that's fine. Like I said, I'm happy with the 14 Pro Max. Yes, I do want the 15 Pro Max, but where am I going to get $800 to add on top of... they want me to pay $1,600 at first because I have the app on my phone. And then what they want me to do is they want me to send in my phone. I think I have to take it into an Apple center. They take the phone. They do whatever they need to do, all their tests. And once they're happy with the phone, then they will refund me the... I think it's $800. And then I have to pay... from the $1,600 you've already paid because they get the payment first. You send in your phone, and then when they're happy, then they refund you the $800, I think, and then they take I don't know how much it is, but it's slightly more than the $800 they give you. So I don't know how much they refund me. I don't think it's half. They take slightly more, and then they give you slightly less, but you will get a refund. So that's how the Apple trade-in goes. So, I wanted to do it. I really wanted the Pro Max. But then I started hearing about all these heating issues. The iPhone's getting really hot. It's heating up, blah, blah, blah. You can't use the Type-C cables for the Android. You need to use the one that's meant for the iPhones. The phone's heating up and all this nonsense. And I'm just waiting to see what happens. Like, are they going to fix it? Are they able to fix it? And then once they fix that problem... You know, I've got a warranty until next year on my iPhone. So I think until March of next year. So with the warranty itself, it's got repairs and stuff. I mean, they will give me the trading value because it's got a warranty on it. I mean, the warranty covers repairs, you know. So I mean, even if there was something that I don't know, there's nothing wrong with my iPhone. I'm telling you, the only thing is the paint. You know, the paint on the cameras. I don't know if it comes off or if it's showing something. I'll just get a magic marker and color it in. I mean, besides that, the camera area. I mean, the phone is fine. When I say the camera area, I mean the color. You know the color. Like if you're putting different cases on the phone and you keep taking the cases off, then you're going to cause those kind of little chips on the camera. But it's not something physical. It's not a. I'll need to take a video of the phone and then I'll put it online and then you guys will see what I'm talking about. It's not major. Even if you look at it, I mean, you would not notice it if you're buying my phone. If I was selling my phone and to someone and someone was without even telling him. If I said nothing about the camera thing with the chips and stuff, you wouldn't say anything. Because the camera works. I'm recording videos with it right now. What I'm talking about is the color. I don't know what else to say. You know that color, that... what can I say? All right. Let me get my other phone, then I'll show you what I'm talking about. This is the Reno. On the Reno here, on the iPhone, the cameras pop up a bit, right? So it's these circle things. One of them, some of them are whitish, but the rest are black. That's the only thing I'm noticing on the camera, on the back. It's got no chips, it's got no scratches. The screen is perfect. The screen is like 100%. That's what I'm talking about. So it's not scratches, I don't know what to call them, or what you would call them. Trying to get first kill. Where's he going? Trying to get him. Trying to get the kill. I don't think I could get him. Oh, it's not first kill. We've already got some stuff going on. Right, guys, I'm going to make another video.